Jesus is the true fisher of men. Dear brothers and sisters, in today's gospel passage, we hear Jesus teaching the crowds about the kingdom of God by making use of an example that was very familiar to them, that of fishing. It is useful to note that while narrating this parable, Jesus himself was sitting in a boat on the sea. To the simple crowds that gather around Jesus at the seashore, Jesus appears to be the true fisher of men, a task which he also invited his disciples to share in. In today's parable, Jesus compares all the people in the world to fish that live in the sea. Both good fish and bad fish live together in the same water, just as good and bad people live together in the same world. While the fish might think that their life and their entire world is in the water that surrounds them, there will come a time when they will be put out of the water and separated. So also, there will be a time when we will have to leave this world and this earthly life and go to face judgment by none other than Christ Himself. Those who have lived righteously will receive an eternal reward, while the wicked will go to eternal punishment. Dear friends, this simple parable reminds us that our earthly life is merely temporary and that there is a far greater life that awaits us, for which we must be prepared so as to be judged worthy to enter into it. It would be a great mistake to be so distracted or fascinated by the passing world, so as to forget that we are created for eternal life and happiness with God in heaven. Today the Church celebrates the memorial of Saint Alphonsus Liguori, a saint who, in his early years, was preoccupied with worldly things. He was a successful lawyer and a prominent member of society. When he lost an important case, he quit his career and put his worldly life behind him. He lived the rest of his life entirely for God, devoting himself to preaching the word of God and ministering to all people, initially as a priest and later as a bishop. He also founded the Congregation of the Most Holy Redeemer, also known as the Redemptorists, to preach the good news of redemption to the poor. At the end of today's gospel reading, we hear Jesus saying, "Every scribe who becomes a disciple of the kingdom of heaven is like a householder who brings out from his storeroom things both old and new." This was also true of Saint Alphonsus, who distinguished himself for his writings on moral theology, in addition to spiritual works of great renown. May his intercession and example help us to live our earthly lives in accordance with the values of God's kingdom.